فوربيدن توماس لينس اتزيوست بي ويتشزان سورسرز. هيلو ماي فرنس، This is the second part of Shams al-Mawarif. Today we will read two five facts about this book. First, the origin of the book Shams al-Mawarif. Second, who is the author of Shams al-Mawarif? Third, why is solitude preferred? Fourth, rumors about the book Shams al-Mawarif. Fifth, the reasons for the ambiguity of the author's personality. The origin of this exciting book is attributed to its Algerian author, Ahmed bin Ouli bin Youssef. He is one of the adherents of Sufi doctrines. He came to Egypt as a young man and stayed there until he died. He wrote many Arabic books that were highly appreciated by readers. Many clerics and others considered him a sorcerer and sorcerer. This is because he published this book, which many charlatans took as a guide for them in the magic they perform. It is the reason behind the emergence of charlatans and charlatans in the Middle East since its inception until now. Ahmed bin Ouli al-Bawni, the author of Shams al-Mawarif, received his education in many countries. This man lived a strange life, preferred solitude and not mixed. His meals were small and he always preferred to fast. One of the places where he spent most of his time was the mountains of Tunis. History did not mention that this man had children or friends. He was known for his strong debates with clerics and scholars, although many testified to his good morals and calm mind. People used to go to him to find out from him what the future holds and what could happen tomorrow, because he had foresightedness and a future vision in various matters. One of his most prominent predictions was the collapse of many countries, as he expected the coming nations, in addition to describing the rulers and the events that they might be exposed to in the future. Rumors credited about the book Shams al-Mawarif, perhaps because it is the only book that Ahmed bin Ouli al-Bawni wrote in this work, or in which he talked about methods of preparing jinns, spirits, unseen, and the secrets of the servants of God's most beautiful names and God's greatest name, compared to the rest of his writings, which are all classified as religious books. In fact, there is contradictory information, as some assert that the original virgin of the book aims to talk with the jinn and communicate with them only, while what is related to her nisv. Kings of the jinn benefiting from the man involving the many fil operations is not mentioned in the book, but is attributed to him, and was mentioned in the distorted copies. Also, the majority of publishing has confirmed that the existing copies of the book are fake, and the name and fame of the book are exploited in order to make profits behind the sale of copies. All the symbols mentioned in the book are not easy to understand. The book regained its ambiguity, incomprehensibility, and clarity from the ambiguity of the author's personality itself, due to his instability in a certain country and his preference for solitude. In addition to his keenness to sleep over mountain peaks, and this raises doubts about him, as something that he was communicating with the jinn in these places, and these are just suspicions, is not entirely correct. On the other hand, many believe that he used to spend the night in the mountains in order to worship and seek livelihood, because they found chapters in the book that present supplications that would bring livelihood. In conclusion, thank you for watching the full video, and do not forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel. And bye.